Hey everyone, and once again, welcome to WS Cube Tech. Myself, Omar Taskeer. Because in this particular video, we are basically going to learn that how can we actually connect Google Analytics with our Google Ads account. So for running remarketing campaigns or for importing different kind of audience, which is there in our Google Analytics platform, what we have to do, first of all, we have to connect our Google Analytics account with our Google Ads account so that we can basically bring the audiences from Google Analytics to Google Ads, right? So for this, we have to follow a complete process, right? So you can see on my laptop screen over here, I have a PPT over here, which says that what we have to do is we have to create audience based on how they are actually interacting with our website. So we have to create audience based on the interactions of our website, like the people who are visiting on any web page of our website, right? So we have to create that kind of audience. And for that particular purpose, we have to use Google Analytics, right? So Google Analytics, first of all, Google Analytics is already connected with our website. So once we have the access of Google Analytics, we can create these kind of audiences within Google Analytics platform, which is actually interacting, or the audience which is actually interacting on our website, right? So we have different steps. Now we have to import this particular audience in our Google Ads platform. And for that specific purpose, what we have to do is we have to connect Google Analytics with Google Ads. So it's like three individual platforms or entities are here. One is our official website. Another one is Google Analytics. And the third one is Google Ads. So we have to integrate all these things. So to make our integration smooth, to make this process smooth, we have to install Google Tag Manager. Now, Google Tag Manager is another free tool which is provided by Google itself. And what this tool does is basically, once you have connected Google Tag Manager with your website, now you can definitely go ahead and basically install different kind of analytics tools or scripts using Google Tag Manager on your website. So every time you want to install like Google Analytics on your website, you do not have to access your website's code. What you have to do is simply you have to go to your Google Tag Manager account, and then from Google Tag Manager account, you can connect your Google Analytics to your website. So whenever we want to connect any tool, or we want to fire any script, or we want to implement any script on our website, we will be not going to the website directly, or we will be not accessing the code of website directly. What we will be doing is basically we'll be going to our Google Tag Manager account, and from there we can integrate the tools or the scripts on our website. So now in this particular scenario, or in this particular process where we are actually looking to get these things done, what we have to do is, first of all, we have to create a Google Tag Manager account over here, right? And then we have to connect Google Tag Manager with our website. And then we have to create another Google Analytics account, and we have to connect this Google Analytics account with our website using Google Tag Manager. So these will be the series of steps that we have to do in this particular process. And once all these steps are done, now we can easily go to Google Analytics and we can find, or we can work on the audiences which is interacting with our website, and we can create this audience and we can import this audience into Google Ads. And once we are done with the audience, once the audience is there in our Google Ads account, what we can do is we can create campaigns around that particular audience. So we have to do all these steps to basically enable remarketing on our Google Ads platform. So in this particular video, we will be talking about integrating Google Tag Manager with our website, and then creating a Google Analytics account and integrating on our website using the Google Tag Manager, right? So we have to do all these things. So once all the integration are done, once all the integration are made, it will become easier for us to understand the complete process. So let's begin, and let's come to our website over here. So we have a dummy website over here, which one is like this, parchamclasses.com. So we'll be connecting Google Tag Manager with this specific website only. We'll be connecting Google Analytics with this specific website only, right? So what you have to do is basically you have to come to Google Tag Manager, right? And you actually need a Google account to access Google Tag Manager. So first of all, what you have to do is you have to create your account. Now let us create an account on Google Tag Manager, and then we will connect this Google Tag Manager with our website, and afterwards we will be firing different kind of tools or the scripts, basically the codes on our website using GTM, right? So first of all, what we have to do is, our step number one is, we have to connect Google Tag Manager with our website. So let's put the account name, right? I am putting WS CubeTech over here. Let's select the country, India, and let's take this thing where we are saying that, okay, we want to share our data with Google so that Google becomes more strong. And now we'll come back to container. So in container, we have to write the name of our website, which is personclasses.com. Let's do it. This one is the website. We can set up Google Tag Manager for different properties. If we have different target platforms like iOS, Android, AMP, and the server. But for now, we will go ahead with this web because we do need this web integration for now. So let's click on this web, and then we'll be clicking on this create, and then we will click on this yes, right? So there are like some basic steps that we have to follow, right? So let it load first and see. Okay, now here it is. Now we have these codes that we have to install on our website. So now this is the website that we are actually going to use, right? So I have removed the content of this website because it was creating problems. So do not worry if you are not seeing anything over here, but the domain is same, right? So do not worry, fine. So let's begin. And now what we have to do is, we have to integrate these two codes on our website, right? At the back end of our website. So we'll be simply clicking on WP admin over here, and we'll be going at the back end of this particular website so that we can enter the required codes, right? So what we have to do is, we have to go to appearance, then we have to go to this theme editor section over here in the appearance, and then we have to go to this header.php over here. Once we are into header.php, what we have to do is, we have to pick this code from here, and we have to put this code into the head section, which is mentioned over here also, right? As they are suggesting us that you have to paste this code as high as in the head section as possible. So we'll copy this and paste it into the head section. Then we have another one over here, which we'll copy and paste into the body section. So we'll come back over here and we'll paste this code into the body section. Now we'll click on update file, and our codes will be implemented. Now we have to check this thing that whether our codes are properly implemented or not. So we have to open our website over here. And now what we have to do is, we have to install this little extension over here, which is a magical extension, right? So the name of this extension is Google Tag Assistant. And as soon as your tags are integrated, what you will see over here is, it will show you that, okay, now your website has a tag, which is Google Tag. So Google Tag Assistant will basically give you the details of the tags, Google Tags specifically, which are there on any website. So if you are onto your competitor's website also, or if you are onto any other website also, then also, if you have this Google Tag Assistant over, you will be able to identify or figure out that what kind of Google tags are there on this particular website. Now we are done with the Google Tag Manager part. Now what we have to do is, we have to simply click on this thing. We have to submit, we have to publish, we have to continue. We have to follow these kind of basic steps, and now that's it. Now our Google Tag Manager is all set on our website, right? So once we refresh this thing, we can again confirm over here. We can come back, we can click on this thing, and you can see it's like CD over here, right? CD mentioned over here, and you can verify by using this unique number which is given over here. So we can come back over here on our GTM, and we can come back over here at this workspace section, and over here we can see the same number or the same code is present over here, unique code, which is there on our website also. Now we have to do the another part, which is like, we have to set up analytics. So if we do not have any analytics account, what we can do is, we can simply click on analytics.google.com, and from there we can create a new analytics account, and then we can integrate this account on our website, right, using GTM. So one thing that we have to follow is, we have to use GTM, right? So we are going to use this specific ID, which is Google Ads course in English, for setting up Google Analytics on this specific website, right? This ID we used for creating Google Tag Manager also. Now we'll click on setup for free, new account name, WS CubeTech, and then we have to do some basic settings over here also, as we did in GTM section. Then we have to select the property name, which is Percham Classes, and we have to do the basic reporting time setup and everything. We have to select India over here, and currency will be INR. Here it is. We will select this thing, and then we will click on show advanced options and create a universal, because we need, right now we are sticking ourselves to universal analytics property only. And then we have to enter our website URL, which is like this one, right? So we have to enter our website URL from here. We have to remove this thing. And like right now, we are sticking only to this Universal Analytics property. We are not going for GA4 property, right? So you do not have to worry. Right now, we are only seeing the integration. Now, what we have to do is we have to click on next. Then we have to do some very basic setup over here. And we have to select all these things. So kind of a basic setup. Now I have dismissed it. Now we are going to set up Google Analytics, right? So what we have to do is we have to go to Google Tag Manager. We have to click on this tags. And now we have to click on this new, right? So we can simply write like Google Analytics, Universal Analytics. Then within tag configuration, we have to select Universal Analytics, this one. Then we have to create a new variable over here for basically tracking ID. So we will pick the tracking ID from here, Universal Analytics tracking ID, we'll paste it over here. And then we will give it a name like Universal Tracking ID or UA Tracking ID. And then we will click on save. Now we will again click on save and we have to add a trigger over here. So we'll simply click on trigger and we will assign all pages trigger because we want to integrate Google Analytics on all the pages of our website. Now we'll again click on submit, publish. So we have to follow these kind of steps. These are very basic steps. Now our GTM is already connected. Now our Google Analytics is also connected. So now we'll come back on our website. And as we know that this magical Google Assistant tool is over here. So that now this one is our website and we have to come back to this Google Tag Assistant to check whether Google Analytics and Google Tag Manager both are properly associated or not. Now everything is connected. The basic things which we were required are now connected, right? So we will come ahead on our Google Ads, right? Which one is this one, right? So we will come back to our Google Ads account and now we will link Google Ads account to the Google Analytics account. So we have to follow these kind of very simple, very basic steps. And these are like one-time setup. You have to set up Google Tag Manager on your website only once. You have to integrate Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager and your website only once. And you have to connect your Google Ads with your Google Analytics account or the platform only once, right? So you have to do all these things like only once. So you have to be very careful while setting these things. So once you are over here at this tools and setting option, you can go to this linked account section over here. So from here, we can easily link Google Analytics. So we'll simply click on Google Analytics over here. And you can see this particular analytics property is by default showing over here. Why? Because we have common IDs for both the platforms. We have common ID for Google Ads. We have common ID for Analytics. We have common ID for Google Tag Manager. That is why this is showing over here, right? So what we have to do is we have to simply link it like we have to basically start the data flow. So we have to link this thing. And once this is linked, our Google Analytics property is absolutely linked now. Now we can create the audience and we can import that audience here into our Google Ads account. So these kind of basic things are required while setting up like Google Ads, Google Analytics and GTM, right? So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.